Welcome to your quick bite of cloud engineering. I'm Laura, and today we're here to chat about resources. So what exactly are resources? In cloud computing, resources are the fundamental building block of any infrastructure or system. A resource can be anything from a server to a network to a serverless function to a security policy or anything in between. If you're familiar with object-oriented programming, a resource is basically an object. A resource, like an object, has properties, like a name or an ID. You can interact with a resource through a function call or an action, just like an object. When you select a button to perform an action on a web portal for your cloud provider, the button makes the function call for you behind the scenes. So to come back specifically to cloud engineering, we need to add to each resource the idea that it has a state to track, and the various platforms have different ways to interact with each resource. Resources can be used to build systems, just like you might expect from a building block. On their own in a cloud-based environment, a resource doesn't do much. Generally, you can't deploy a functional application with a single resource. Now, before you point at something like a serverless function and claim that resource can hold a single application, think about the security policies, the networking needs, and other pieces that any cloud provider requires to set up that function to interact with some data. All of those additional needs are also considered resources. On some cloud engineering platforms, you can group resources together to make a resource group, which often acts just like a resource. Sometimes they're called custom resources. You might even find some platforms set the base level that defines a resource at the point of a resource group instead of a resource. It's turtles all the way down. To put an application out on a cloud-based platform, you need to string resources together to make up the infrastructure underneath your application. For a basic example, you can consider a static website that has a storage bucket resource holding the files, which also are resources as each file has properties to reference and a state to consider and a way to interact with it. And then there's a security policy resource for that bucket that allows someone to access the file from an external address. Any cloud-native architectural diagram, really, can be expressed in resources and interaction between those resources that are then defined in your code. This has been your quick bite of cloud engineering for this week. If you liked this video and want to see more, please do like and subscribe to our channel and check out the Quick Bites playlist. Also, if you want to learn about something specific, leave me a note down in the comments. I do read those. Or open an issue in our GitHub repo that I'm going to link in the description right now. I'll be back in just 2 weeks for another Quick Bite. Take care. Bye. Hey, cloud engineers. Laura here. I'm just here to remind you that if you have a topic you would love to have us cover here on Pulumi TV, all you have to do is go to github.com/Pulumi/Pulumi TV. You can add an issue there and let us know what topic you'd like us to talk about. Thanks so much. Bye.